Hi, I'm Ranger Allen from Dinosaur Valley State Park. I'm here today to take you on a geology hike through time along our limestone ledge trail, where we will look at different examples of weathering, erosion, and deposition. After that, we are actually going to walk through time as we unearth how our dinosaur tracks became visible through the process of weathering, erosion, and deposition. So join me on this geology hike through time today here at Dinosaur Valley State Park. So we've made it to our first stop here along the limestone ledge trail. As you can see, I'm standing in a small little canyon and standing next to a rock that has a huge crack right in the side right here. Now this large crack was formed from weathering. Now anytime we talk about weathering, it's very important that we talk about the three forces that cause weathering to take place. We have wind, water, and ice. Now this specific area right here probably was formed by ice. Over time, water seeped into this crack, which probably started out as a very small hole or chip in the rock. Now what normally happens to water when it freezes? It expands and gets bigger. So over time, the water seeping into this small hole or crack eventually got in, froze during the winter months, and expanded to actually make this large crack right here. The other forces, water and wind, actually can help break apart these large pieces like this, slamming against the surface, weakening it over time, and breaking it down to where we can actually see the difference. So while this piece right here is not fully separated from this one, I'll meet you at our next stop along the limestone ledge trail. Well, we will look at a piece of rock that has been fully separated completely from the original piece. So I'll meet you at our next stop. So we've reached our second stop here along the limestone ledge trail. And as you can see, I'm standing in between two pieces of rock that have completely separated from each other. Comparing to the last stop along this trail, the rock had cracked, but it hadn't fully separated. Weathering broke down that piece through wind, water, or ice, and did the same thing right here. However, it has completely separated and moved to a different location. That movement is what we call erosion. Rock breaking down and moving somewhere else is that erosion that we need to worry about. Now, after erosion takes place, there's one final step that happens, and that's when the rock actually stops where it is and sits there and actually stays put. So here's a little model to represent that. Is I have these two little pieces of rock right here. And as you can see, holding them together, there's a little crack right here in the rock. Now just like at the previous spot, wind, water, ice, got in here, formed that crack, and eventually over time, broke this little piece off from this rock. Now, looking here, I'm moving this piece over to this side, just like this piece has moved 3 feet over from the main surface of the rock. As soon as I set that rock piece down and it stayed put, that's what we call deposition. Deposition, the dropping off of those pieces of rock that are eroded away. So weathering, breaking it down, erosion, moving it, and deposition, dropping it off. So now that we've talked about all three of those things and the three forces that cause weathering, I'm going to meet you back at the main track site where we'll actually walk through time and look at how weathering and erosion actually impact our dinosaur tracks here at the park. So I'll see you back down at the main track site. So here we are back at the main track site. While we were up on Limestone Ledge, we talked about how weathering breaks down the rock through wind, water, and ice. Erosion being the literal movement of those broken down pieces somewhere else. And then deposition actually dropping off those pieces of rock in a different location. So looking at our dinosaur tracks right here, what if I told you that weathering and erosion is the reason that we get to experience these tracks and that those forces unearth more tracks for us here at the park? Now, looking at these tracks right here, these sauropod and theropod tracks, what do you think actually unearthed these tracks right where I'm standing? Really, it's the Paluxy River. The running water actually unearthed these tracks right here so we can experience them all. In 1938, Roland T. Byrd made this important discovery of the world's first sauropod trackway right here. Without weathering and erosion, the water coming in of the Paluxy River, breaking down the layer of rock that was covering these tracks and removing it somewhere else, we would not have these tracks right here to experience. However, unfortunately, because these tracks are now uncovered, the Paluxy River will destroy these tracks over time. The water will come in, break down those rocks through weathering, and erode them to different locations where they'll be deposited somewhere else. So we should all be lucky that we get to come out and experience and see these tracks while they're still here for us to experience. So come out, see our dinosaur tracks here before weathering and erosion destroys them forever. So we've covered a lot on our geology hike through time here at Dinosaur Valley State Park. While we were up on Limestone Ledge, we looked at weathering, erosion, and then deposition. Weathering, the breakdown, erosion, the movement, and deposition, it dropping it off somewhere else. So come out, visit us here at Dinosaur Valley State Park, hike Limestone Ledge, and see if you can find other examples of weathering and erosion here at the park, or if you can't make it here, in your local community. I'm Ranger Allen. Thank you for joining me on this geology hike through time here at Dinosaur Valley State Park. I'll see you next time.